Yes, welcome all to APJ eZenith. I would just request all of you to please switch on your videos. Thanks a lot. I would request the participants as well, if they can switch their videos on, that would be much better for us as well. Let's start then, let's dive in. Today is the result day for the APJ eZenith, that is the national level online event that we were conversing about for the last 1 week. We got a good response from each and every sphere of a nook and corner of India. But before we indulge into that, let's start the event by praying to the God with this lamp lighting session. Santosh sir. Thanks to the Almighty for all that we are getting in life. So it is my pleasure and privilege to welcome you all to the APJ eZenith 2022, that is the national level online event. Good morning to all of you. I welcome Director Sir, Dr. Rajesh Pagha, Director of the Institute, Deans Dr. Rajneesh Arya, Dr. Kulwant Kaur, Dr. Rajan Chaudhary, Dr. Avdeep Deora, all my co-coordinators for the events, the faculty members, and special thanks to all the participants for sending in their entries and making this event possible. So let me give you the brief gist of what is eZenith. First of all, we have eZenith, we made it with the intent to provide an opportunity to the youth to exhibit their talent and skills. So we included three activities in this: poster making, declamation, solo dance. And to give equal opportunity to the young minds, because the young minds, we divided into two categories. Category 1, 15 to 18 years age group, and category 2, that is 19 to 24 years of age group. So to reach out to every nook and corner of the country, we decided that it will be given an online platform. And it took the shape as APJ eZenith 2022, the national level online event. And to reward the young minds, cash prizes was kept. So the first prize being 3,100 rupees. Second prize, 2,100 rupees. And the third prize of rupees, 1,100. Get each. So third prize of rupees, 1,100. Which the results would very soon be out with you. So I invite Dr. Rajesh Pagha, Director of the Institute, to address the audience. Director, sir.
Very good morning to all, and thank you, Aman.
Welcome, sir.
So first of all, on behalf of our APJ Education Society, New Delhi, faculty, staff, and students of APJ Institute of Management and Engineering, I welcome you all on the occasion of virtual national level inter-school competition. And I extend a heartfelt thanks to all of you for being here. My dear students, why we followed this time the virtual national level inter-school competition. Otherwise, it is our annual feature, and we used to organize offline in our campus, whereby more than around 50, 60 schools, more than 1,000 plus students, they used to participate in around 20 plus events. But this time, we were waiting for the COVID pandemic restrictions to be lifted out so that we can organize this. But by the time, by 31st March, when all the COVID restrictions were withdrawn by the government of India, in such a case, at that point of time, all of you were having your annual examination listed. I think CBSE is commencing their annual examination by April 26. But just glad to share with all of you, yesterday we just had our inter-college mega event known as an APJ Spark, in which more than 1,000 students across 30 colleges across all over the Punjab, they participated in this. And today we are having listed three events: poster making, declamation, and solo dance for 18 plus students, as well as for inter-school. So I am really delighted that we have received a wonderful response from all across the country. And I am proud to announce that we have received participation from different states of India, including Tamil Nadu, Odisha, Jammu and Kashmir, Uttar Pradesh, Jharkhand, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, and some UTs of Chandigarh, New Delhi, to name a few. And we are really delighted and grateful that you accepted our invitation and participated with such a zeal and passion. And the entries we received in all these three categories, solo dance, poster making, and declamation, brought forth remarkable skills of the youth of our country. Little bit about APJ Education Society. APJ Education Society is having niche in imparting the academic excellence. Institutions being run by APJ Education across the country. And ours, APJ Institute of Management and Engineering, comes into existence in the year 1997. We started with our MBA, MCA, BBA, BCA, BCom program, and we introduced 5 years back our engineering programs. We are running BTech Computer Science Engineering. And apart from this BTech Computer Science Engineering, we are also running BTech Computer Science Engineering, Artificial Intelligence and Machine Learning, and BTech CSE with Internet of Things, Cybersecurity, including Blockchain Technology. So just highlighting few of the achievements of our institute, but I am really delighted. I am really thankful to all the judges. Those have given judgments from so many entries received in the three events. And it was really tough and difficult for all the judges to go for the entire entries being received across the country. And I think the event coordinators, Mr. Aman Pratap, Mr. Daljeet Matharu, and Mr. Sunny Gulati, along with the team of all deans, around 3 to 4 judges in all the events, they participated while finalizing the final entries. And I think later on, the event coordinators, they will guide you. Out of so many entries in these three respective events, around they have shortlisted 5 entries each, and then the first, second, third prize comprising of 3,100 rupees for the first prize, 2,100 for the second prize, and 1,100 for the third prize being announced. So all my young students, let me tell you all, if we leave no stone unturned to provide our students with the best of resources, facilities, opportunities, and most importantly, such member of faculty who have competence to turn someone average into extraordinary. All this fructified in the form of our students turning out to be really confident, enterprising, and well-skilled and employment ready. Just a few days back, I received the news of some of our MBA students getting placed in Accenture. 90% students in MBA 2021 batch have already been placed. As many as 55 companies have hired our students this year. Top-notch companies like Jaro Education have selected our students at a package of 9 lakh per annum. Some students have been placed in upgrade at a package of 8 lakh. On other leading recruiters, including TCS, Wipro, Accenture, Smart Data, Byju's, SDFC Bank, Asian Paints, to name a few. These companies have selected students at lucrative positions of digital marketers, data analytics, etc., business analysts, etc. Really glad to share that more than 100 students did live projects in 25 companies last year. It really brings us great joy when our students bring laurels in the different fields, to be it academics, co-curricular, or even begging placement offers. It is also a matter of great delight that we could help in showcasing of skills all over India through this event. We are glad for your wonderful participation and expect that we will have a long lasting association from here. So thank you so much. My best wishes to all the participants, and hope you will do really good in the days and years to come. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, sir, for your kind words. Truly, we are the best placement institute in terms for MBA, MCA, BTech, BCA, BBA, and BCom. So coming back to the event, I would invite my co-coordinator, Mr. Daljeet Singh Matharu, to guide us about the process and the entries for poster making, declamation, and solo dance in two of the categories. Daljeet, sir.
So before Daljeet, just excuse me, Aman, in okay. case if you can drop a link of our social media links in chat box, so students, they can copy that, and later on they can have photographs and the announcements, etc., that we will put in our social media platform, so that they can get in touch with our institution.
Sure, sir. Sure, sir.
Thank you, Aman, sir. Very good morning, Dr. Rajesh Bhagat, Director of the Institute, Dean's School of IT, Dr. Kulwant Kaur, Dr. Rajan Chaudhary, and Dr. Rajneesh Sharia, Dean's School of Management Studies, and Dr. Vineet Dura, Dean School of Engineering and Technology. Myself, Daljeet Singh Matharu, being a culture coordinator, we are going to start with the session, long-awaited session. Before, as mentioned earlier by Dr. Sir and Aman Sir, so it's basically an online mode to reach to the maximum to the people across India. So it's an eJanith, which is an online, you can say, national level event. Okay, so we have the session, which is basically we had event coordinators, like including me and Mr. Amar Pratap Singh Pal, faculty from School of IT, and Mr. Sunny Gulati, a faculty from School of Management Studies. So as mentioned earlier, this event was announced a week back. We have been inviting to the different schools and colleges to participate in. So this event includes three major events, which includes poster making, declamation, solo dance. And the prizes were like, first prize includes 3,100, and second one 2,100, and third one 1,100 rupees. So I'm briefing about the general guidelines which were followed in order to participate in the event. We had introduced in the posters as such a one QR code, whereby the student is supposed to scan the code and he was able to register for the event. The second one, we had introduced a Google form as well, where the students were supposed to fill in the entries for registration and get themselves registered and can upload their videos as well. The third option, which we had chosen for, like the students were supposed to email their entries, videos in case of a solo dance, and video in case of declamation, and pictures, stages, clicks for the poster making. So for ensuring that you are falling into the right category, we are supposed to send the age proof, which is going to be your school ID or your Aadhaar card or your matriculation certificate. So the last entry was 7th of April midnight, and the obviously announcement to be done today only. So if I start with the category one, so the session is designed in such a way that we will be dealing with the category one, three events, and then category two, three events. Let's start with the first category, category one. Category one caters to the students falling in the age group of 15 to 18 years. The first event is poster making. And let's talk about the rules and the judgment criteria for the event. So as the name poster making, so definitely the poster is supposed to be based on some theme. And the theme was for this category one, colors of India, the essence of culture. Okay, so it was the theme on which the students were supposed to depict in the form of a poster. So the rules were like from each participant, one entry was expected. The poster was supposed to be in full size, and obviously the pencil, crayon, watercolor, oil paint, etc. were supposed to be used, and original work was supposed to be there, and the posters were supposed to be sent into the JPEG format only. And the judgment criteria, definitely the relevance of the theme, originality of the work. To ensure the originality, even the students were supposed to click the poster images by having the different stages depicted that it's their original work. Artistic composition, creativity, message conveyed to the through the poster, and the effectiveness in communicating the intended message, that whether it is associating with the theme, colors of India, the essence of culture. So we received in this category more than 42 plus entries in this category, and it was very difficult for the judges, but still they shortlisted the top five entries for the same. So here are those entries. Over to Santosh Mishra, sir. So these are the five teams which were shortlisted.
So, Dilji sir, can you see the images?
No, sir.
Right now, not available.
So we have shared the link of our social media platform in the chat box. So yeah, so this one is the poster presented by, I will not be disclosing the quotes here. So these are some of the shortlisted posters here from the category one. So this is the second one. The third one, and team code is T15 here.
Just name the first, second, third poster. First one.
Yeah,
was...
we will be naming the winners. Just we request the students just to wait for a while. Okay, we are just here showing you the list of shortlisted entries only. So among these five, three were basically declared as winners. For second, third, we will be announcing them soon. It's just a view of some of the creations by the students who participated in poster making in the age bracket of 15 to 18 years. This is team T21. This is team T15. This is team T5. And who team T5 is, that will be declared in the form of results. Okay, we'll be disclosing their names once we will be in the next part of the session, then we will be displaying the results as such.
So just to add into this, after declaration of the result, the winners of the same category, first, second, third, they are supposed to send the poster by post on the postal address being sent to all of you through email. So I think event coordinators, they will be doing this.
Yes. We expect the students who will be the winners to stay in touch with us, because obviously in order to get their prizes, they are supposed to verify their age proof from their respective schools and colleges as well. And they are supposed to send their bank credentials as well. So moving next to the second event in this category, that's the declamation contest, whereby the rules were, obviously it's a declamation, the students are supposed to speak on a topic, and the topics that were given to the students, one is effective learning style, electronic or traditional. So it's going to be a much debatable issue, again, a hot topic for a declamation. And the second one, the world peace, is the idea of peace on earth nave. So these were the two topics which were given to the students to speak upon. So the rules include, like, the students or participants were supposed to speak in either Hindi or English, and they were supposed to record their videos in the MP4 format, and they were supposed to obviously send in good resolution quality and the audio, because it's a declamation, obviously the voice of the speaker is supposed to be prominent and the clear one. And the time allowed was 3 to 5 minutes, and the judgment criteria includes content greeting and introduction to the subject, exposition of the main theme, conciseness, clarity of the message, and the originality, and the points of interest related to the topic they had chosen from the topics like effective learning style and the world peace. So among the declamation contests in category one, we have shortlisted few entries, and now again we are showing you just a brief view of these shortlisted entries. Over to again Santosh sir. So these declamation, here we had received more than 32 entries.
Well, what makes you go to war? Asked Pierre. What makes me? I don't know. I have to. Couldn't have been worded more sagaciously elsewhere than in Leo Tolstoy's War and Peace. Greetings, everyone. Standing before you is Shobhna Agarwal, a 12th grader from APJ School Mahavir Marg, Jalandhar, Punjab, presenting her endeavor to answer the rhetoric, "Is idea of peace on earth naive?" Peace. As complacent as this word sounds, the turbulence goes beyond semantics. Can tranquility be preceded by punitive strictures on arms and weapons? The answer is yes, fleetingly. Perpetually, never. For a placated regime to prevail, people must not refrain themselves from taking up ammunition due to fear of draconian laws. But because no quest for power can now impel their conscience to turn up to violence. And when a sweeping change has to come from within, well, that's where things get a bit tedious. The psychology of violence emanates not from the avarice of preeminence, but from the fear of being subdued. To be indomitable, people cause actions that endangers the autonomy of others, which exhorts them to further take up arms, thus creating the lethal paradox which turns this world into a place much more uninhabitable every passing sunset. The tragedy of war is that it takes man's best to do man's worst. July 16, 1945. The first ever nuclear explosion was tested. An invention impeccably trailblazing. August 6, 1945. That same invention obliterated hundreds of thousands, for America feared the strength of its rival. or take the everlasting Israel-Palestine discord, where both the sides claim to be shielding themselves from antagonism. Not to forget the recent notorious Russian invasion of the former Soviet nation, which has been gestated by a threat of prejudicial Western expansion. So, to answer the conundrum, is the idea of peace on earth naive? Well, it might be. But if we have learned one thing from history, other than genocides and incursions, of course, then it is to never give up. Yes, the world we live in today is grey. It's despondent. But we carved this. And now, this is our responsibility to remodel it. For if we continue to walk down this lane, then one day we shall laugh at our naivety for how we thought we could hand down guns in hands of our children today and then expect flowers on our graves tomorrow. Thank you.
This was the first one selected entry from the declamation in the category 1, which falls in the age bracket of 15 to 18 years. So we can play one or two more.
Humans are the most abundant resources on the planet. Yet, ironically, humanity is the most scarce resource of all. Good morning, everyone. I am Manas Mutneja of Class 12th of APJ School, Mahavir Marg, Jalandhar. Today I am here before you to present my views on the idea Earth Peace. Is the idea of peace on Earth naive? I don't know if war is always pointless, she said. I know it is always tragic. Peace is not a utopia. It is a reality in progress. Majority of the people on Earth have realized that war is only a cowardly escape from the problems of peace. Peace is not something which can be referred to as silence or discipline. It is a state of mind. It cannot be achieved if a country as a whole does not stop being greedy, selfish, and envious of the achievements of the other countries. We are but equals on the same land. The more time we take to realize this, we are only going to delay the inevitable. It is up to us if we want peace through war or without it. The wars over thousands of years should have been enough to teach us about loss and grief. I thought we knew now that war can never bring about any change. But what can bring peace on earth is listening to what the other desires and trying to negotiate. Everyone in the world was shattered when we heard of Russia's invasion on Ukraine. And over what? That Ukraine wanted to be an independent country? That all that Ukraine wanted was to be like the other European countries? And what was Russia's excuse? It felt unsafe? William Shakespeare has rightly said, "It is excellent to have a giant's strength, but it is tyrannous to use it like a giant." After the Hiroshima bombings in Japan, it excluded itself from the whole world. And today it is more advanced than any other country. But at what cost? It would have been good if it would not have suffered through war. But there are signs all over the country. People have been left suffering through diseases and disabilities for generations to come. We should not have let history repeat itself. We should have learned from it. But we didn't. All we can do is have pity on someone who has gone through a war. All our country can do is show sympathy to the other country going through a war. But when it comes to ourselves, the horror is beyond imaginations. And why war? I ask every one of you. Are we not happy to be alive? Are we not grateful that we have roofs on our heads? Are we not grateful to God that we were not part of the wars which came and went? Are we not intelligent enough to know that war is not worth the blood it costs? Peace can only come if we want it to. It is not a goal, it is a necessary requirement. It is no wonder that if we ask anyone today if peace is possible or not, they will answer in negative. Peace can only come if we let go of the war. Have you ever wondered why our country needs armies and weapons? It is because man does not trust the other man. It is a shame that we all, being of the same species and with all our talk of peace and harmony, cannot trust each other. Last but not the least, I will only say that if we keep on leading our lives as we are right now, we are going to say to our enemies being none other than ourselves, I beg you, leave me not in this eternal darkness to rot. But maybe we know not. In the future, there will come a spot when there is nothing left but sorrows to sort. Thank you.
So it was the performance by team T13.
So many good entries. I think definitely must have been really difficult for all the judges to shortlist even five. Everyone, whosoever we can listen, so is giving wonderful ideas.
Very true, sir.
Let's move to the other one.
Yeah.
Peace, a word that signifies hope, a word that signifies communal harmony, and a word that is signified by the color white. And there are several examples to justify this. For example, the color of the uniform of our forces is white. White is included in the national flag. Even our uniform is somewhat white. But the true question today is, whether the white of the whole world is enough to reflect the darkness of some. Hello everyone, my name is Siddharth Chima, studying in class 12 from APJ School Mahavir Marg Jalandhar. And today I'm here to speak on the topic world peace. Is the idea of world peace naive? Well, if you ask me, the question is wrong. Because peace is not an idea or a concept. It is the very significance of the human race. It is the very essence of our human spirit. Today, we all have created boundaries within us in the names of social division, different nationalities, different cultures, different race, different castes, and whatnot. And in the name of protection of our identity, we have forgotten the identity of who we truly are. The culture of what we call togetherness, the nationality of what we call earth, and the religion of what we call humanity, and the true meaning of a five-letter word called peace. Today, I ask a simple question. How many more wars would it take for us to understand that peace cannot be translated into a 12-digit figure that is spent in the names of so-called protection and defense? It translates to us coming together as a whole, and understanding that we are Earthians, that is, citizens of Earth and ambassadors of peace. As Jawaharlal Nehru has rightly said, peace is not a relationship of nations. It is a condition of mind that is brought by the serenity of soul. Peace is not merely the absence of war. It is a state of mind. Lasting peace can only come to peaceful people. Today, I propose that we all stand resilient. We stand with the spirit undaunted, and we stand for peace. In the end, I would like to say, broken were the walls, stained were the hearts, deep are the wounds, scorching in the dark. The world is united, but broken are the walls. Today, I ask you, was it worth it all? Was it worth it all? Thank you, everyone.
It was an entry by team code T17.
Greetings of the day. My name is Raghav Gupta. I'm a student of class 10 and I'm 16 years old. Today, I'm going to share my views with you all on the topic, is the idea of peace on the earth naive? Peace is something that many of us hope for on earth. It is something that many people work for, strive for, and die for. But is it possible? Is it possible to unite the countries of the world and live in peace and harmony? In my opinion, peace is defined as a state of mutual harmony between people or groups. This statement often tells us that peace on earth is something that cannot be kept by force, but it can only be achieved by the mutual understanding among people. Peace is a state of calmness between people where fighting or disagreement does not exist. I feel that today the pen is mightier than the sword, and many treaties and negotiations have ended wars because people are willing to sit down and discuss their issues. However, I believe in our lifetimes the entire world will not be completely at peace, since there are so many different opinions between world leaders. Looking at the crisis globally for monetary gains, resources, or power, I am forced to doubt the existence of humanity. Us, the Homo sapiens, have been party to so many wars since decades. World War II, Napoleonic Wars, Mongol Wars, and the list goes on. World history is a proof that war and violence has plagued us and has not resulted in any solution. The global economy was already reeling from the effects of the COVID-19 pandemic, and the current conflicting situation between Russia and Ukraine poses a significant threat. As an aftermath of the Russia-Ukraine conflict, both the countries as well as the world are affected. Many innocent people unfortunately became victims of this tussle. It's disheartening and frightening as well. In fact, this war is also leaving significant consequences, including the trickle-down effect on other parts of the world. So many students from different countries, including India, have been stranded there. In fact, with the Russia-Ukraine war not seemingly nearing an end anytime soon, the students are worried about their future as well. Even though evacuation camps have been set up to rescue people, it always disturbs me to see that anyone can bomb civilians. It's a disaster, a sob story, and a harsh narrative. We might face problems and things that might not be in our favor, but we can have better solutions instead of war. How can we forget about the bombings at Nagasaki and Hiroshima? 76 years since this incident took place, its prolonged effects are still visible. It yet cripples the generations of those survivors. Bloodsheds, loss of life and property can thoroughly be avoided if we choose the path of harmony. Peace in the world starts with each and every one of us. It is a blossoming flower whose quintessence can be felt by each and every soul. As I find my own inner peace, I spread that into the world outside of myself. The Buddha once said, "Peace does come from within. Do not seek without it." And I am highly inspired by this quote. As nations become more peaceful, the world becomes more peaceful. And this whole snowball effect begins with our own search for inner peace. Thus, we each need to plant the seeds of kindness and peace in the world. One thought at a time, one decision at a time, one act at a time, and one day at a time. I have read one article that stated that after the Cold War fought between USA and USSR, the world was plagued with conflict and peace that had been lost on earth. The United Nations was an instrument to regain and maintain peace and harmony on earth. In the words of Ronald Reagan, peace is not absence of conflict, rather it is the ability to handle the conflict by peaceful means. Certainly, all of us would agree that a war is the worst. It creates chaos, causes bloodshed, as well as disrupts the global economy. Therefore, wars should be banned all over the world, and the leaders must find an alternative to war and bloodshed. This could be a peaceful solution. We cannot allow our future to be eaten away by the acids of hatred, division and conflict and mistrust. India is seen as the greatest example of unity in diversity. We have an amalgamation of different religions which all preach one thing, that is peace and harmony. If we began to see ourselves as separate entities from our community, nature, then violence and strife arises. So it is time we rebuild our world and make peace with nature and most importantly with our own selves. To lift each other up, we should promise this to humanity. Let us promote activities that are aimed at assisting our neighboring countries emerge from conflict, reduce risks, and lay the foundation for sustainable peace and development. In summation, peace on earth is the mother of progress. Thank you.
Education is the most important weapon which can be used to change the world. Warm greetings to one and all. My name is G. Shreya and today I am here to express my views on the topic effective learning style, traditional or online. As we all know that generation after generation, we people change many activities. This COVID-19 suddenly entered into our lives and has completely changed the platform of education. And now we all students are opting online education or e-learning, which is in a trend these days. But the most important question which arises is, which one is more effective, traditional or online? Well, I completely feel that traditional classes are way more effective as compared to online classes, because I feel that tradition should not be broken and traditional classes are called traditional due to some reasons. Yeah, I completely agree that there are some benefits of online classes. For example, there's no need to travel out. Just by sitting in one corner of our house, we can easily attend all the lectures. But there are way too much benefits and a lot of comforts in traditional classes. The most important is communication. Traditional classes offer a better interaction with students, classmates, friends, and teachers. And students can learn, understand, and grasp all the concepts easily in traditional classes by facing the teacher face to face. And teachers can easily explain all the concepts with the help of laboratory methods. For example, by taking them to science lab, maths lab, exhibition, etc. In traditional classes, students are advised to be disciplined, to sit silently, and just listen to the teachers. Whereas you all know that in online classes, a lot of mischief is being created by the students. In traditional classes, students follow a scheduled and fixed timetable, which helps in managing the time, whereas it's not possible in online classes. In traditional classes, students can easily compete with other students and can easily complete their homework in the classroom.
additional classes are important because Gurukuls, which are an important tradition of India. So, my dear friends, let's all turn up to traditional classes. They are more effective. Thank you.
So, it was Team T29.
So we move to the next category now, solo dance.
Okay. Fine. So the next category is solo dance. Let's go through the rules and regulations for the same. One entry, one participant. And the competitors can dance to a song of it or her choice. Dance steps, moves, gestures, and the song itself should not cross the decency. Competitions should show full creativity and freedom to submit the freestyle as well. Duration was expected to be 2 to 3 minutes, and the students or student participants were supposed to record their video in HD means 720p or a higher resolution in MP format. And the judgment criteria includes unique moves and variety, quality of dance and execution, and the degree of difficulty. So the top five shortlisted entries are for this. Let's see the performance of the top five in this category. Over to Santosh sir.
Thank you.
Let's go to second entry. What is this? E6.
I will take care of business. Understand.
T28. Lovely performance it was. Darjeet sir. So let's move to the another category, category 2, which is consisting of the age group 19 to 24 year age students. In this category, again, we had the same type of events. Like the first one was the poster making. If I go through the rules, here the topic was different. The theme on which the students were supposed to prepare the poster, so that was different. Here the topic for poster making was lifestyle after a pandemic or war. So again, the rules are almost same. The students were supposed to prepare one poster, full-size poster, uses of colors like crayon, pencil, watercolor, oil paint, okay? And original work was supposed to be depicted through different clicks of the poster making, and it was supposed to be depicting the themes clearly. And then the four photographs were supposed to be submitted, and they have submitted, the students are submitted through email or any other mode like Google form which we had shared. And the poster was supposed to be submitted by 7th of April midnight and in the form of JPEG format. The evaluation criteria includes the relevance to the theme, originality, artistic composition, creativity, message conveyed through the poster, and effectiveness in communicating the intended message, like message was the lifestyle after pandemic or world war, or war, sorry. So the entries are, this one is T27, T51. So if we move next, in this we have the event declamation contest, where the rules were the language to be English or Hindi. The participants were supposed to record on the topic given, and obviously with the full HD quality, audio to be clear, and 3 to 5 minutes duration. And the topics given were patriotism and national building. And the second one was governance for sustainable development. The judgment criteria includes content, greeting, introduction to the subject, exposition to the main theme, conciseness and clarity of the message, and originality and points of interest. And here, if I talk in general, we have received more than 22 plus entries for the same, and the best 5 are:
land where rivers are personified, the land where values are worshipped, the land where diversity creates a beautiful rainbow. India is the land of Manu, Chanakya, Maharana Pratap, Mahatma Gandhi, and Major Shaitan Singh Bhati. Respected judges and my dear friends, I am Alka from Army Institute of Management and Technology, Greater Noida. When India respects all religion with its secular culture, when our mother country depicts to the world that we believe in divinity and not in imperialism, when this nation cultivates peace and harmony for the whole world at this very moment, I think the topic patriotism and nation building gives immense pleasure and relevance in this context. So, patriotism. According to the word of Mahatma Gandhi, patriotism is like this. For me, patriotism is same as humanity. I am patriotic because I am human and humane. Imperialism has no place in my course of patriotism. Patriotism is thus like our love towards our mother. My mother is always superior to me, but it doesn't mean that other mothers are inferior to me. This is what patriotism means. We Indians respect and love our country, but at the same time we respect policy and formulations of the other foreign countries. Coming to the nation building and organizing a structured plan procedure mainly to attain a nation identity, this is what a nation building means. It is very close to patriotism. Before discussing this topic in a wide sense, first of all, we have to know the global perspective of patriotism and nation building. The Year 1789 is very heroic in the history of mankind. You know why? A slogan called Liberty, Equality and Fraternity flourished throughout the world through French Revolution. This revolution not only revolutionized the people of the France but every nook and corner of the world. Thus, patriotism got empowerment. Coming to the nation building, the turning point in the revolution called American independence. Coming to the Indian perspective of patriotism and nation building, in Ramayana, Ram says that my mother and my mother country depicts to the world and that they are more greater than heaven itself. Chanakya in his Arthashastra clearly defines concept called patriotism and nation building. When we go through the timeline of Indian history, lots of faces have made commendable contribution in patriotism and nation building. The Great Revolt of 1847 gives us Mangal Pandey, the sacrifices of Subhash and Indian national movement led by Mahatma Gandhi has institutionalized patriotism through concepts like
Santosh sir, I think we should go for the excerpts, the highlighting the only main points for 2-3 minutes.
As B.R. Ambedkar made India an ideal model.
Santosh sir, I think we should go only for the excerpts for 2-3 minutes, or 1 minute or so.
I am Rohit Kumar from
Daily. So the next one, T11.
Present my views on sustainable development. Sustainable development is an overarching paradigm for the United Nations. The concept of development was described by the 1987 Brundtland Commission report as development that meets the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. There are 4 dimensions to sustainable development: environment, culture, and economy, which are intertwined, not separate. Sustainability is a paradigm for thinking about the future in which environmental, societal, and economic considerations are balanced in the pursuit of improved quality of life. For example, a prosperous society relies on a healthy environment to provide food and resources, safe drinking water, and clean air for its citizens. One might ask, what is the difference between sustainable development and sustainability? Sustainability is often thought of as a long-term goal, that is, a more sustainable world, while sustainable development refers to the many processes and pathways to achieve it. Example, sustainable agriculture, sustainable production and consumption, good government, research and technology transfer, education and training, etc. The Sustainable Development Goals, SDGs, also known as the Global Goals, were adopted by the United Nations in 2015 as a universal call to action to end poverty, protect the planet, and ensure that by 2030, all people enjoy peace and prosperity. Countries have committed to prioritizing progress for those who are furthest behind. The SDGs are designed to end poverty, hunger, AIDS, and discrimination against women and girls. The creativity, know-how, technology, and financial resources from all society are necessary to solve the SDGs in every context. To date, education for sustainable development has been integrated to many global frameworks and conventions related to key areas of sustainable development. Thank you.
Let's have a brief look at the next one now. We'll be playing as of the paucity of time, so we'll be playing for short duration only. So those are, we can play for 1 or 1.5 minute.
Good morning, everyone.
This is done. We can next.
The rivers are
done. Yeah, this is done.
Good morning, everyone. I am Rohit.
What nation has done for you, but ask yourself.
So, okay.
We can move to the next event, sir, if we can, because most of them are being played now.
The next event in this category is solo dance. So if you look at the rules for the event, one student per entry, competition to be competitor supposed to dance on the song of his or her choice. Dance steps, moves, gestures, and the song should not cross the decency, and it should show full creativity, duration 2 to 3 minutes. The students are supposed to record in full, you can say, so 720p or HD quality or higher in the MP4 format of the video. And the judgment criteria include unique moves and variety, quality of dance, execution, and the degree of difficulty. And we have received more than 55 plus entries in this category. So after a rigorous, you can say, shortlisting, our panelist shortlisted 5 entries, and here are those.
For 1.5 or 2 minutes only, because of the we are really running out of time.
I think by forwarding, sometimes it hangs up, so we can continue with this.
Okay, sir.
So next one. So
E14 it is.
Okay.
T70.
Less man, more baddies. What's that? It's a drop top caddy. What's my name? Bob Daddy. Big tunes got.
Lude up in the morning, I roll up and count my money.
I'm so wavy, I'm so wavy, I'm so wavy, I'm so wavy.
All my bitches love me, they gon' answer for a real one.
I'm so wavy, I'm so wavy.
So I think we must appreciate and applaud the efforts of different students from schools and colleges across the country.
Truly, so, sir, truly.
Very true, sir.
Really, they deserve this.
So,
time for results now, sir.
Yes, please go ahead.
So now the much awaited
time. Excuse me, sir.
Yes, who is this? So let's see who the winners are. The
excuse me, sir. Hello. So
please come up with your video.
Hello. Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, my performance was not there in solo dance category.
See, we have received in solo dance more than 60 entries. So we are not able to play all the performances in this session because of the paucity of time. Okay, so we have just shown only the selected few only. Okay, so we really apologize for this, that due to the paucity of time, we are not able to show all the performances in the session, because otherwise the session will be too lengthy for us to continue with. Okay. So, maybe go ahead now.
Yes, sir. Yes, please.
So, the much awaited time has come. Let's start with the winners' names. Obviously, so far we have mentioned about their codes only. Okay, now let's view the codes and show you who the winners are. So moving category wise, the first one is the category 1, 15 to 18 years winners. And let me announce that in this category, we have again three prizes. The first one, first topper is supposed to get 13,100, and the second one 2,100, and the third one 1,100 for the same. And in the first category of poster making, Ishita Thakur with team ID T5 have won the third prize, that's 1,100. Congratulations to Ishita.
Congratulations.
Congrats, Ishita.
Next one, second prize in the poster making category is T15, that is Vishesh Vij. Congratulations to Vishesh Vij for winning the second prize, that's 2,100. And the first prize in this category goes to V Mithili, and the team code is 27. And the student has won the first prize, 3,100. The second event in this category is Declamation. The third prize in this category goes to T21, and the student name is Raghav Gupta. Okay. And the next, congratulations to Raghav. And the second prize in this category, which is 2,100, goes to team code T13. That's Manas Mitneja.
Congratulations
to Mitneja. And the first prize Declamation goes to T17, and the student name is Siddharth Jima. Congratulations, Siddharth, for
congratulations.
Moving to the solo dance category, the third prize goes to team T11. Name of the student is Tushita. Congratulations, Tushita, for winning the third prize in solo dance in the category 1.
Congratulations.
Second one is Navjot Kaur. She has won the second prize. Her team code was T6. Congratulations, Navjot.
Congratulations.
And the first prize in solo dance category one goes to T28. That's Misha Puri. Congratulations, Misha.
Congratulations.
3100 as the first prize. Let's go. Go to the category two. Let's move category wise. The first one is poster making, and the third prize in this category goes to Team T51. Name of the student is Karuna. Congratulations.
Congratulations.
And the second prize goes to category in this category of poster making. T43 is the team code. Remember, this is Sezal. Okay, congratulations, Sezal, for winning second prize in poster making.
Congratulations.
The first prize in this category goes to Team T21. Name of the student is Ankita Rehal. Congratulations, Ankita, for winning first prize in the poster making category of 19 to 24 years of age group. And moving to the next, we have declamation. Third prize goes to Team T12. And the name of the student is Bhatika.
Congratulations, Bhatika.
Next one is in declamation. The second prize goes to T6 team with the name Alka. Congratulations, Alka.
Congratulations.
And in declamation, the first prize goes to Team T14, Karanveer. Congratulations, Karanveer, for performing very well in winning the first prize in declamation. And the last event in this category two is solo dance. The competition was really very tough. It was very difficult for the judges to declare the prizes after with the rigorous evaluation to come up with the winners. And the third prize in this category goes to Team T17, and name of the student is Samartha. Congratulations. And the second prize in this category of solo dance goes to T7. And the name of the student is Harshita. Congratulations, Harshita.
Congratulations.
And the final is the first prize in solo dance category. That goes to Team T21, Ishan Sibar. Congratulations, Ishan, for winning the title of even get the first prize in solo dance. Okay. So with this, we come to the end of prize declaration ceremony, and let's now raise for the national anthem. Over to Aman sir.
So before this, I must say all faculty members with their audio on must congratulate and compliment all the students from different schools and colleges across India.
Congratulations, everyone.
Congratulations.
Congratulations to all the winners.
Congratulations, everyone.
Congratulations, everyone. Thank you so much, sir, ma'am. Yeah. Over to Sunny, sir. I would now call to Mr. Sunny Gulati.
Thank you so much, sir.
Co-coordinator for the event to propose vote of thanks for this.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Good afternoon, everyone. It gives me immense pleasure to deliver the vote of thanks for the APJE Zenith 2022, a national level online event. First of all, I extend my sincere thanks to the Almighty God for his blessings and making this event a great success. A special mention to our Honorable Director, Dr. Rajesh Bagaji, for being a support system and being there always as his pillar of strength. My heartfelt thanks to all the participants of all the events from different parts of the country, including states and UTs like Punjab, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Jammu and Kashmir, Youth Uttar Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Jharkhand, Chandigarh, Odisha, Maharashtra, New Delhi, and many more, who made this event as a national event in real sense. We have been very impressed and touched by their zeal and passion. I'm thankful to the all judges who accepted our invitation and spared their valuable time to judge various events. My sincere and heartfelt thanks to all the deans, the organizing team, and all the event coordinators, and my co-coordinators, Mr. Aman Pratap Singh, and Daljeet Singh for their guidance and support. I would also like to thank the people who worked behind the scene to make this event happen by mentioning Mr. Santosh Mishra and his team for their technical support, our social media team members, Mr. Kamal Gurleen Singh and Mr. Rahul Handa for putting the event at various social media platforms. The members of the press committee for the coverage of the event, Mr. Bhanu for making all the arrangements. Last but not the least, I'm also thankful to all the faculty members, non-teaching staff, supporting staff for their contribution and support for the success of this event. Once again, I thank each one of you. Thank you so much for being with us. Thank you.
Since we have come to the end of the session, thank you very much. So let's play the national anthem, the ending.
Jaya Gana Mana Adhinayaka Jaya Hai Bharata Bhagya Vidhata Punjab Sindh Gujarat Maratha Dravida Uttara Vanga Vindhya Himachala Yamuna Ganga Uchala Jaladhi Taranga Tava Shubha Name Jage तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे
जय 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 हे